we're all here for a reason. It's a safe space and a judgment-free zone, so if you have advice, feel free to give it, but just remember to keep your words calm. Enough of that, shall we start with some introductions? Say who you are and why you think you might be here. Elwyn, is it? Would you like to start?
Hi, I'm Elwyn, I'm 21. I'm here because I feel like I'm in a world that wasn't designed for me. Like I'm walking the same path as those before me, but with a different roadmap.
Wow. This shit got dark real
fast. Thank you, Juno. Why don't you finish?
Hi, Juno, 22. Look, I'm only here because my parents wanted me to be alright. There's nothing wrong with me, obviously. they seem to think I repress my emotions instead of dealing with them, which is apparently a bad thing.
Like I said, you know, we're all here for a reason. What do you think next?
Hi, I'm Noah, and I guess I'm here because I'm out of options.
Well, it's always nice to see new faces. I mean, it's not nice to see more people than Sam. What do you think?
I'm Ophelia, 23. This is my third time here. I know how you feel.
Thank you.
now.
At least this is going to be hard. I don't expect you to make
any difference. I'm sorry, I can't do this anymore.
It's always like this.
Like what?
Well, you know, the first session scares people.
That boy, Juno was it? He looked at me like he'd seen a ghost. I think I frightened him by what I said earlier.
Which thing was that? You're the first person to come in here and fill this room with colour in years. Like an iridescent beam of light.
Iridescent? The thing I said earlier that scared Juno was that moving in the right direction doesn't excuse you from being late to the destination. What I meant was, my family excused their hatred of me being gay with the excuse that they're getting better at accepting it. But I just think it's ridiculous, you know, thinking you get a gold star for almost loving me. There's something so haunting about being unloved by those who brought me into this world.
Understand each other, and I mean, I don't need to move a muscle, and you kind of know what I'm thinking.
I feel the same, but I still understand that it's hard to open up about the things that only you've only ever truly understood.
Yeah. The only real emotions I've felt are fear and love. But I've always wanted to feel loved, like truly loved, not in that scary, angry way. I feel disposed and...
Go on.
I can't explain it, really.
Then play it.
Play it?
Play your pain. I'll be right here with you.
We live.
You can have a room in my metaphorical house any day. My home is yours.
Thank you. Anyway, that's enough crying for today.
You seem to carry so much weight around with you.
Yeah, I don't know. I've always looked out for other people. It's kind of been my main focus and kind of forgotten about myself, really, and how to love myself.
I understand, but it's not your job to look after everybody.
Isn't it funny how we can give the best advice and not really follow through with it?
I know what you mean. Yeah. Anyway, it's getting late. We should probably go. Would you like another home? I don't think either of us should be alone right now.
Yeah. Thanks. You know, third time, it's a charm.
Third time's a charm?
Well, I don't know. This is my third time here. This group, this might be my last. I'm actually excited for a world of tomorrows.
Don't you want to try?
Try what?
To be a better version of yourself. To learn and grow. You can't do that without us. You need to be here. You need us.
I guess I never really thought about it like that before. But also, I'm terrified.
Terrified of what?
Who I am? What I am?
And who is that?
Well, I think I might be bisexual. I don't want to be. I'm terrified of what people might think of me if they'll accept me.
Have you ever said that out loud?
No.
Thank you for telling me. When you allow yourself to be who you are on the inside, you see the world with so much more colour. Everything is iridescent.
What?
Nothing. Coming out and giving yourself a label gives you a sense of belonging. There's a whole community of radiant souls who make the dark moments pass quicker.
I guess I never really thought about who or what I am. I just am, and that's a privilege I didn't even know I had until now. But I do think about it every time I wake up.
Thank you.
you.
I can't believe those words came out of my mouth. I spent so long lying to myself, terrified of what others might think of me, if they'd accept me. And then you, you accepted me without even knowing me.
No, I hope you don't mind me asking, how many families have you been with?
Pretty much been bounced around my whole life. I can't really remember most of my childhood or earlier teenage years, but if I had to guess, I'd probably say 8 or 9. The family I joined 5 years ago was 10.
So sorry to hear that. That must have been really difficult dealing with that much rejection and abandonment. I think that might be my biggest fear.
Being abandoned?
Yeah.
My first couple of films, the rejection I felt, it was pretty overwhelming at the time. But all I can remember now is pain, and honestly, it just made me stronger. I had to face my biggest fears because I simply didn't have a choice. And I think life is just kind of like that, you know?
Yeah, it's scary. Waking up and not knowing what he's going to hold for you, whether you'll come out 24 hours later, better or worse. Most days I think you can't get much worse, but I hold on to a better tomorrow, and each tomorrow just seems to get darker. I'm breathing in the final
love for me is the feeling of familiarity and feeling comfortable, but it's a feeling that I've always known but never really felt.
Yeah. I like what you said about familiarity and comfort, but we do need to be careful with that too, because we learn to believe love is an emotionally unavailable thing, whether that's platonically, romantically, and we draw ourselves to emotionally unavailable people, normally as a result of being raised by emotionally unavailable parents, but we learn to believe it's an emotionally unavailable dynamic, and so we're drawn to people that select what we believe love to be based on.
What if we're drawn to people completely opposite to that?
Well, I guess it doesn't have to mean anything. People are drawn to each other for all kinds of reasons. Humans above all want connection. connection, whether that's shared music taste or identifying with someone else's struggles. We just want to feel like we belong here.
I really like that. Love for me used to feel so black and white. Now it's hopeful, colourful, even. It's still scary.
I don't know what it feels like to be loved. I'm not sure I even know what it means.
You don't know what means?
Love, I guess. What does it mean to be loved?
What does it mean to be loved? You ask, what does it mean to be loved?
Socialising with a stranger and getting stuck with them the whole night just doesn't really appeal to me. Like, I'm not shy, like, far from it in the right situation. I just prefer the company of a select group of people that I've accumulated over the years. Although, saying it like that does make me sound like a psychopath. I love my friends, I just don't have that many. And I'm confident but introverted. And I have a social battery that runs out really fast, so even when I'm charged up and social
mind, I'm going to stop now.
Can be yourself with me.
I like you, but you have to give me a chance because no one's ever made me feel so at home before in such a sad place.
If I was a fire,
This opportunity and bringing us all together. I feel like, I know it's been hard, but the journey we've been on from where we began to now has just been magical. I'm so proud of everyone and I really hope we can stay in touch.
Safe and secure, and I've seen what healthy love looks like. I feel like everyone's become so much more authentic, including myself, and I'm pretty proud of myself for that.
What a lovely sentiment, Darren. Thank you, Bina, too. Oh, I just feel this room is so full of warmth and love right now, so thank you for such a wonderful panel session.
Ephemeral fires and eyes that see so deep, I'll always wonder what to lie to be loved iridescently. Kaleidoscopes of soul that feel so real, I'll always wonder what it's like. Golden
is this, should I feel
by thanking you all for your hard work and determination. It's your strength that's carried you through these past weeks. I'm so proud of how much you've achieved in such a small amount of time. So proud. It's not going to be easy. There'll be things you need to continue working on, but hopefully now you know what it means to be loved and how to find a home within yourself. So your journey will continue with support, but most importantly, love.
Hold me as I fall asleep. I lie there as I feel you breathe.
You exhale, then inhale all of my dreams. Now we're dancing on the moonlight.
The haze hits your eyes as the stars whisper words of deceit.
Thoughts in the shape of rain clouds trickle down upon your nose.
Earth brings us back home. Feel the roots that we've sown.
Feel the lump hit your throat as you fight back the tears
of remembering where you're from.
That place that we know as home.
I'm breathing in the summer air. Oh,
thank you so much for your support. We really appreciate it. This is something that Amber and I have written together, and it means a lot to us. So thank you so much. And yeah, we hope you enjoyed.
Thanks.